Surely, I hope, needs no introduction. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm welcome to Mr. Charles Rowe.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my great pleasure to welcome you here on this fine afternoon. I have witnessed with my own eyes the remarkable range of enticing products and foodstuffs arrayed within the market today. And I thank you wholeheartedly for resisting their lure for an hour or so. My name is Charles Rowe. I expect many of you will know me. If there are those who claim ignorance, I shall not take umbrage, although such an occurrence would speak ill of our education system. I am principally a man of business. I made my start in the button and twist trade, but my natural aptitude for commerce led me to the production of silk, and later the mining of copper. Through these endeavors did I build an ample fortune, which, as the son of a humble minister, I strove to employ for the betterment of this town and her people. I'm also a freeman of Macclesfield. In my day, such a title conferred upon the bearer the right to elect our parliamentary representatives. It appears that such a privilege is now afforded to even the common man. Which brings me to my purpose here today. Within the span of the next fortnight is an event of no little import. I speak naturally of my 300th birthday. Indeed, it is frequently remarked that I am in excellent health for a man of such advanced years. But the secrets behind my vigour are surely matters for another time. Of course, ladies and gentlemen, I jest. In truth, I speak of the forthcoming election and the attendant uncertainty. Few would deny that much hangs in the balance, and thus the vote you cast should be an informed one. To that end, this event shall serve to illuminate the characters and politicians of these your parliamentary candidates.